Okay, today I will give you a bit of talk about the halal food products recommendation based on knowledge graphs and machine learning. So this work actually is not only me, but we have a team in here, Nadif, Puspa, Suci, Ade, and Rarasmaya. We are from Institute of Technology, 10 November. So I'm not going to talk about me because Chitan already explained that, and then I just skip it. Okay. What is interesting about the halal food? So the halal food is in global, yeah, global Islamic economy said that report that Muslim in the world spend $2 trillion for halal food, yeah, each year. So you can imagine how people need halal food every day. So that they want to make sure that what they eat is halal, it's masjid halal. So what is halal? So before I jump to the Neo4j and anything good stuff, so I would like to see you what is halal. Halal is refers to a code of conduct that permitted by Shariah, which is Islam rules that applies to every activity. It's not only for food actually, but all the things. But in terms of halal, yeah, in terms of halal, we can say that the simple way that we can say halal, like in maybe in another way like kosher or anything, halal is mean there is no alcohol, no pork, no blood, dead meat, and the meat must be slaughtered by cut names. So that means halal in Islam, I mean in simple way, but actually it's a bit complicated if how halal food product must be processed. So it's not only the ingredients but also how is the process. Okay. So next is how we have proposed. Yeah, we propose something use the machine learning and knowledge graph to make recommendation between if we have food. Yeah, if we have food product, how we know that this food is also halal and we can make recommendation based on that food. So basically, we do some preparation. So we crawl the data from the Indomaret, yeah, and then converted in graph. So I will explain later. And then we use the graph feature extraction. We just use Neo4j graph data science libraries. If you see, there's common neighbor, preferred attachment, total neighbor score, label propagation, Lufin, and then we have also do some data labeling, which is actually, we use this Jaccard similarity, which is also provided by Neo4j. But after that, we do it manually because we just make sure by there is something, maybe some ingredient or some company, the Jaccard similarity is very low. But after we check manually, the halal, the product is not really similar or maybe similar. So that's why we have to check one by one. And then after that, we use the machine learning, use KNN, naive bias, and random forest for use this extraction features there to the these three models. Okay, so what is our data set? So our data set is from the Klik Indomaret, is one of the biggest grocery shopping in Indonesia. It's not only online grocery shopping, but they also offline, yeah, offline grocery shopping in Indonesia. So we got the data of around 660 products, and then after that we also combine them with the LP POMUI product. This is one of the halal auditor in Indonesia, yeah, in Indonesia, which is in this Klik Indomaret we don't have any label halal, yeah, in there. But after that we use the LP POMUI data set, so and then we integrate them, and we found that some of maybe 50% of the Klik Indomaret data set already halal, but some of them unknown. Yeah, we don't know this halal or not. So that's why we combine all these data set together. And then if you see, I have the graph data modeling turtle in here after we got the information data from the LP POMUI, yeah. You see in here, this is our data in turtle in semantic web format, which is the prefix and so on. you can get this information from this GitHub. This also part of our members in Halal. And if you, I can see to the mine. Yeah, this is, you can see in here, there is a lot of products, yeah, in here. Yeah, you can see this. And then after that, after modeling that, we import the data to Neo4j. For that, in the Neo4j, we need these plugins. We need Apox Graph Data Science Library, and also this Neo Semantics library, because we our data in already in Tuple RDF, so we need to import to the RDF. So okay, and then we import the data to the RDF. We use the this Neo Semantic. You can see in okay, I will see you my my this one. Yeah, okay, so this is this one. So I import the data, yeah, to the our data. So especially I choose the ignore because I don't want have the prefix in Neo4j. This is a bit messy when we do some query, and then we import. So you see that's how many triples are load already load in this one. And then we got the data, yeah, after we import, and then we have the data like this. So this is, if you see this one, so I just limit to 25. You can see how is the data in the Neo4j. We have this one, manufacturers certificate, the seller certificate, and also so on, yeah, something like this. Okay, and then after import all the data, and then you, this public, yeah, open data, you can use you can also create by yourself in your data sets. And then after that, we also this one, the result, and this one, yeah, I already see you in the Neo4j, this one, our manufacturers and so on, contest ingredient. And then after that, we try to use the features of all the graph algorithms, yeah, in data science library. We use the common neighborhood and then prefixal attachment, TN for the total neighbors, same community, this for the, and also SL, yeah, for the, this one for label propagation, this one for Lovin. So we use all these parameters. And then if you check in the Neo4j like this, see this one, I will show you the this one. Okay, so this one, how we use this, we get the CN. So this use this graph, yeah. You just can see all these things, CN, common neighborhood. So you, we use the content ingredients in here. So all the food product, and then where it contains ingredients, yeah, and then the URI should be not the same. If the same is always one, right, the similar products, and then we calculate, use the link prediction common neighbor, and then the all the things, yeah, prefer PA, SN, and SL. Okay, just for remind you, if you use this one, you must use the Neo4j for wait, for 4.5, because I somehow I just running this morning for the new Neo4j for Neo4j 5, yeah, 5, it doesn't work. So you have to use this Neo4j 4.5 at least, yeah, so you can get all this algorithm works in your Neo4j desktop. And then after that, when we already have this one, this will be used the features for your machine learning models, yeah. And then after this one, yeah, this I just make it in table like this, CN, PA. So for example, coffee, this one is coffee in Indonesia, ABC coffee, and then with the ABC syrup, syrup is great sukukran pandan. You say that how many ingredients and how many things that already served, and you see. And then after that, we do labeling, as I said before, we do labeling with Jakarta. Yeah, with Jakarta. It is because it's a simple way to do that. And then after that, not only use the Neo4j library, but we also do it manually because we just to make sure that even the similarity is worse, yeah, we can see this. Okay, I'll show you the Neo4j. Okay, this one. So this is the Neo4j. This is the similarity. There is some zero. This means it doesn't match at all. Yeah, there is no similarity between coffee and then instant noodles. Yeah, so that is instant noodle in here, as I say in here. That's why we also use this one. This one, for example, for coffee tamarins. Yeah. It's similar thing with for vitamargarin cold, yeah, the similarity. Yeah, so we do the labeling is one. It mean it's similar. Yeah, as the same here. And then this one also, okay, this is also similar. We check one by one to make sure the similarity is correct. So if it's higher than 80%, we say this one. But it's less, maybe one or zero. Zero for is not similar. But we have to check, yeah, to make sure that the product is actually similar or not. Okay, okay, and then after that we have the model training. We use 66.67% for the training, and then the rest is for the testing data set. And we do hyperparameter tuning for 10 fold cross validations. For that, if we see this one, our hyperparameter, after we try to all the possible value, this is the parameter for alpha, family 1, 5, and so on. And you can see also for the machine learning, yeah, and this entropy gradient and estimator, something like this. And then we also want to check, yeah, want to check the box plot, because we want to have the...
Yes? Hi, Noor. Sorry to interrupt you, but we only have a couple of minutes left. We are already running a little behind. So if you can, please wrap up a little quickly. Thank you.
Oh, okay, okay. And then this, yeah, you can see the common neighborhood for the box plot. You can see all these things, yeah. We just want to make sure which one features that is really significant. And then this the result, the model result, yeah, which is not related. Mostly is... cross one for the not related, and then so on. This is the training data. And this is the accuracy, the combination from not related labels and related labels. You can see it's higher. And then the random forest is the best for that one. Okay, and our code in here, so I can see my code. Yeah, wait a minute, see. I already said, yeah, if you need that one. So this is, if you see in here, I use the Python in here. Then the features, you can see this one for the box plot. And then we do some hyperparameter tuning in here, as I say. And then I run that one and then got the result of this, all the accuracy, sensitivity, and specificity, as you see in here. Okay. I think that's all for me. If there are any questions, let me know. And then I already shared the code and also shared the data set. Thank you so much.